نستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. عباد الله، فأوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله. Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, when I look around, when I open my ears wide, I see people are talking in the community, people are talking in America, people are talking in the world. And the one of the topic is intikhabat, the past elections, and president-elect Donald Trump. This is the discussion. Some of us are crying, some of us are very, very grieved, some of us are saddened, some of us are saying we wish if Clinton won, some of us are saying why should both of them win, some of us are saying, people are talking, some of us are in fear because whoever migrated to America left war behind. Some of us witnessed many, many dead bodies before they could make it out of the country. For many reasons, people are talking about this. It is my duty as your imam to guide the community towards what can we do. That is part of why I am here. فلذلك عنوان الخطبة today is الإسلام وقضايا العصر وخاصة بعد الانتخابات في أمريكا. That is a very beautiful one. Islam and the current affairs after American elections. People want some guidance. من القرآن والسنة. To start with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ar-Rum, chapter 30, ayah number 1 to 5, Alif Lam Mim. These are known in Kutub of Tafsir as Huruf Al-Muqatta'ah. These are abbreviated letters. No one knows their meaning except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كاف ها يا عين صاد يا سين طه، مع أن بعض المفسرين اجتهدوا فقال يا سين طه مين بميز رسول الله. All these حروف المقطعة لا يعلم معناها إلا الله سبحانه وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says only but in Rome that Romans have been defeated in war. وهم and then وهم من بعد غلبهم سيغلبون. Even though after their defeat, after they have been defeated, they will also defeat the Persians. في بضع سنين. بضع in Arabic is from 3 to 9. يعني تحت العشرة. And so within a period of 3 to 9 years, they will win. Romans will win. لله الأمر من قبل ومن بعد. The matter of giving victory belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All matters belongs to Allah before and after. وَيَوْمَئِذٍ يَفْرَحُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. On that day, believers will be happy. بِنَصْرِ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. By the victory that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon whoever he wills. brothers, Abdullah ibn Abbas, I was just going through Tafsir al-Qur'an al-Azim of Shaykhuna wa'allama ibn Kathir. Abdullah ibn Abbas says that when Romans and Persians fought, Romans were defeated. Al-Mu'minun fi Makkah, believers, wished if Romans won the battle because they were Ahlul Kitab. They were Ahlul Kitab, so they were closer to the believers. Quraysh, Al-Mushrikun wished if Persians won the battle, and they were talking amongst themselves. So when the news came that Persians won the battle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is informing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after Mushrikun had made a statement that, don't you see, if we fight with you, if it happens that we fight with you, we're going to defeat you and we're going to prevail over you, like Romans, your friends, your brothers, lost the battle. We will win and you will lose. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this ayat, غُلِبَتِ الرُّومِ, that Romans have lost the battle. لكن الله سبحانه وتعالى says وهم من بعد غلبهم سيغلبون. Even though after they have lost, they will still win. One day they will defeat Persians and Mushrikun. So this, I decided to mention this because sometimes هناك من يحاول بل من يسعى ليفرق أو يفرق بين الدين والسياسة. There are people who say no, دين is دين, dunya is dunya, siyasa is siyasa. La, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul qul inna salati wa nusuki wa mahyaya wa mamati lillahi rabbil alamin la sharika lahu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, tell the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verily my prayers, inna salati wa nusuki, all my sacrifices, wa mahyaya, my entire life, وَمَمَاتِ, and even my death, لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, all these are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has no partner, وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and by that or with that I have been commanded, and I am one among al-Muslimun, those who submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your entire life is Islam. Islam governs every aspect of your life. Unless you have a proof من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that him as a Rasul and also as a leader of دولة, he يعني فرق بين السياسات وقضايا العصر الدين. فلذلك we can talk about what happens far, what happens among other people, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم victory of Romans who are not Muslims and Persians who are not Muslims. We can talk about it. طيب الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us that المصائب كلها مقدورة. All afflictions, all disasters, all tribulations, tests and trials are decreed by Allah. Allah سبحانه وتعالى wrote them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew about them, and he still knows is al-alim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the musabbib al-asbab. He is causing things to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Quran, Surah Al-Taghabun, Surah Al-Taghabun, chapter 64, ayah number 11. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, ما أصاب من مصيبة إلا بإذن الله. That there is no disaster, there is no affliction, there is no any tribulation or test or hardship that you go through except that it happens by the permission of Allah. We have forgotten Qadr, which is Rukn min Arkan al-Iman. We start pointing fingers and say, oh, we wish so-and-so help us, we wish so-and-so won. We are referring to human beings instead of referring to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا أَصَابَ مِنْ مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. No misfortune, no disaster, nothing happens except by the permission of Allah. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ. And whosoever believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala firmly, whosoever is firm and is steadfast in his iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has a promise for you. يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ. At the time of atrocities, at the time of masa'ib, at the time of humum wal ahzan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it depends on how strong your iman is. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَهْدِ قَلْبَهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide your heart to see and to follow the right thing. وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ. And Allah is aware of everything that happened, that is happening, and that will happen. Al-Qadr is rukn min arkan al-Iman. Many Muslims have abandoned it. Many Muslims have neglected it. Many Muslims have brushed it aside. And now it remains that we want to cry to human beings. We want to cry to the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلِذَلِكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يَقُولُ فَلَا تَخَافُوهُمْ وَخَافُونِ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Do not fear them. Do not fear tree. Do not fear mountain. Do not fear human beings. Do not fear water. Do not fear animals. Fear me alone if you are true believers. نعم. نعم. We have reduced ourselves that we are trembling. One word from somebody, one word from somebody in a position, all Muslims are, now if they kick us out of this country, what is going to happen? What is going to happen to my house? These are the discussions with Buyut al-An, by the Zawj wa Zawdan, wal-A'ila wal-Ahl. We became here and we succeeded. If this Mr. Trump kick us out like he said, what is going to happen? We forget that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the cave, and Abu Bakr is expressing his concern. Ya Rasulullah, if they look at their feet, they will see us, Ya Rasulullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding, is sending Jibreel alayhi salam, ثَانِيَ اثْنَيْنِ إِذْ هُمَا فِي الْغَارِ إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ وَصَاحِبِهِ هُنَا هِي هُوَ أَبُو بَكَرْ صِدِّيقٍ إِذْ يَقُولُ الرَّسُولُ يُخْبِرُ أَبُو بَكَرْ أَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى يَقُولُ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. Where is that aqeeda in us? Trembling, shivering. Some people are asking me fatwa of siyasa, Sheikh, what do you think? I'm not asked to be siyasa. I'm revising Bukhari every day, Muslim, I'm revising, I'm still learning. That's to be siyas. I do not have masters. Ma indi magister wa la natura fi siyasat. Check what do you say, what is your opinion? Yes, what do I say? We are trembling, we are shivering, because some of us don't believe. We just claim that Allah is with us, Allah is taking care of us, but it is not, it has not entered into our hearts. Inna Allah ma'ana. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. Who appoint people, who bestow power, leadership on his creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 26 and 27. I don't need to mention this ayat, but I know that we have masahif al-Quran at home. At least go home and take the dust out away from the mashaf that you have. And then just revise it, and then go deep to the books of tafsir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. Say Muhammad, tell them, Allahumma, oh my Lord, oh Allah, مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ, you are the owner, you are the possessor of sovereignty and kingdom and power, you alone. تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. Oh Allah, you grant, you give kingdom and power and dignity and sovereignty to whoever we wish. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءَ. Not only giving, also you take it away from whoever you wish. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءَ. You may have kingdom, you may have position, you may be a president, you may be a leader. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with leadership and honor. But also what you think, مَنْ تَشَاءَ. You may still have it and you are humiliated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يُعِزُّ مَنْ يَشَاءَ وَيُذِلُّ مَنْ يَشَاءَ. بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرِ. In your hand is all good, O Allah. إِنَّكَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. The only one who is able on everything is Allah. Human being is not able in anything. لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. If you ever thought that you are able, Because sometimes we are committing this type of shirk. I can do everything. I'm able. And we forget that every time when we pray, we say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. إِسْتِعَانَ بِاللَّهِ. You cannot do anything without the power and might of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot do anything without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some of us, having known this ayah, this is chapter 3, ayah number 26, go to 27. So we start saying that, you know, Allah, if it happens, subhanAllah, and we are so down. Many Muslims are so down. Even in Salah, you are down. In Salah. Only one person comes in all our mind. He said. And if you look at the social media, la ilaha illallah. They even portray how Africans are living with their bags and how Saudis are living in their thawb. They are living. People at the airport. Anyone who is on Facebook. It is a big joke. Allah, big joke. It is in our heart and mind. No discussion now. You read all the jara'id and you only find this name. He said, what is going to happen? Do you believe in the following ayah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tuulidu layla fil nahar wa tuulidu nahar fil layl. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who enters night in day. And also he enters day in night. وَتُخْرِجُ الْحَيَّ مِنَ الْمَيِّتِ وَتُخْرِجُ الْمَيِّتَ مِنَ الْحَيِّ. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who takes of dead the living and he takes out of living dead. This is work of Allah, it's not the work of any king or any human being. You cannot die except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it that you have to die that day in that way. Why are we so shaken? الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُهُ اللَّهِ. Don't we believe in that? الَّذِي يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُهُ اللَّهِ. Don't we believe in that? Why are we so shaken? أَيْنَ إِمَانُنَا. Where is our iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَيْنَ إِسْتِقَامَتُنَا فِي الدِّينِ. Where is our steadfastness in deen? That we discuss human being more than Allah. We cry to human being more than Allah. We are so saddened by a statement made by human being that Allah. It is Allah who gives life. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who takes life. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who alternate day and night. وَيَرْزُقُ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Risk is not only in this land. Risk is everywhere. وَمَا مِنْ دَابَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا وَيَعْلَمُ مُسْتَقَرَّهَا وَمُسْتَوْدَعَهَا. Do you believe in that? Allah give me this. But it's not in your heart when somebody teases you that you have to leave. Yahi, you have passport. You are a citizen. Why aren't you touching it? Don't you have a passport? Didn't you memorize 100 questions? Did you? Don't you have a green card? Why are you so shaken? Most of us are not shaken because of deen. Wallahi, most of us are not shaken because of deen. It is because of iqtisad and dunya. My house, my car, my this. This is not where Sahaba were. You can compare where we are and where Sahaba were. Did this happen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or not? فلذلك, the one who gives life is Allah. If Allah wants me to die on the minbar, I will die now. Wallah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to die on the plane, I will die. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to die in the presence, being attended by specialists, 15 of them, I will die. This is our iman. Don't just say it. لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Our statement that we are making, discussions would have been very different. We have to see things in the light of La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. We don't need to see things in the light of dunya. This dunya is coming and going. I want the best of dunya. Wallahi, I want the best of dunya. I want to be a millionaire. I want to be this and this. You want that. He wants that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Mata'un qaleelun. This is a very temporary enjoyment. بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. This dunya is fania. Akhira is khayrun وَأَبْقَى. It's the best. And also it is permanent. We are so worried. What is going to happen with my car? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, collected by Abu Isa, Imamuna At-Tirmidhi. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu says, أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لي الرسول advice me and said يا غلام إني أعلمك وفي رواية إني معلمك كلمات أو young man I wanna teach you some beneficial words احفظ الله يحفظ be mindful of Allah fulfill your duty towards Allah Allah will protect you احفظ الله تجده تجاهه be mindful of Allah be dutiful to Allah follow the teachings of Allah you will always find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on your side at the time of ease and trouble إذا سألت فاسأل الله when you ask only ask of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله when you seek help only seek help with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala oh we are not there it is this quick dua alhamdulillah rabbil alamin then all our hearts is directed towards our bosses it's directed towards Mr. President it is directed towards Mr. King إذا سألت فاسأل الله وإذا استعنت فاستعن بالله واعلم أن الأمة لو اجتمعت على أن ينفعوك بشيء لن ينفعوك إلا بشيء قد كتبه الله لك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم advising Abdullah ibn Abbas means advising the ummah and know that if the entire ummah the whole world comes together think of jinn and mankind and wild animals comes together to benefit you to make you a king to make you rich to make this is our standard very low standard I have a car I'm successful I have a car I'm very successful I have a wife and I'm very successful. We don't want to think beyond that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, Allahumma la taj'al dunya akbar hammina wa la mablagha ilmina. Oh, all that we think is this dunya. If you have a car, you have succeeded. Mashallah, I have a good job. Mashallah, can you celebrate with me, mashallah? I have a promotion at work. Can you celebrate with me? Yani, it's not bad to do that. But do you think only until there or you think beyond that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us there is temporary success. A car, education, this, that. Lakin there is permanent success. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ Until on the day of Qiyamah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has saved you from Jahannam and that He has entered you in Jannah, then you have succeeded. That is the real success. But until when you haven't crossed it out, Until when you haven't been given your book in the right hand, أخي في الله, la 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 la. You need to work very hard. You need to wake up. You should not be in deep sleep like you are. طيب, Rasul told him, if the whole ummah gathers together to benefit you, they will never benefit you except with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. وَإِنِ اجْتَمَعُوا عَلَىٰ أَيَّذُرُّوكَ بِشَيْءٍ And if the entire world, forget about one person, Forget about one military of one country. Forget about, I don't know, united this and that. Forget about that. If the entire world gathers together to harm you, to afflict any harm on you, لَنْ يَذُرُّوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ They will never afflict you. They will never harm you except with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written. رُفِعَتِ الْأَقْلَامُ وَجَفَّتِ الصُّحُفُ The pen which wrote this have been lifted and the pages which recorded this has dried up. Is this our iman or not? Is this our iman or not? Why are we so shaken? Why are we discussing things which are irrelevant? He said, and so said. The country that we live in has a system. And their system is someone has to become a president. A gay can be president. A woman can be president. A man can be president. They don't have a problem. This is their system. We are living here, that is the system. One has to be a leader. As Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have Quran, we have Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that guides us to live outside America and inside America. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, Surah Al-Nisa, chapter 4, ayah number 59. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. Obey Allah and obey Rasul. وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ And those who are in charge amongst you Muslims فَإِنْ تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ If you differ in any matter, should we do it or not? What is your opinion? فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ Refer it to Allah and His Messenger إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ If you really believe in Allah and the last day, ذلك خير وأحسن تأويلا. That is best for you. That is the best for you, and it is the best determination. Did we consult Quran and Sunnah regarding what is happening, even our ahzan, even our humum and humu? Did we, and where, what should be our position as Muslims? Hate has been preached. Syrian refugees, Iraqis, should not come to this country. Muslims will be profiled. We have to register again. We have to go to Fidel of each one of us and register according to what was said. All this, وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. These are not big, the way we make a big deal out of it. الْأَرْضُ أَرْضُ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He created heavens and earth. No one says that he created America, he created Saudi Arabia, he created Jordan. This is work of Allah. الله خالق كل شيء وهو على كل شيء وكيل. The creator of everything is Allah. Why are we so shaken? If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants, you will not die in America. You will die in Japan. You will die in Mecca. You will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already explained that. Now, whenever you run away from al-maut, Allah told al-Yahud, قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم. Death is not following him, it's meeting you where you are going to. It's coming from every direction. أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. نعم, kings الملوك يموتون ورؤساء يموتون الفقراء يموتون والأغنياء يموتون. It doesn't matter whether you are طويل or قصير. It doesn't matter whether you are naive or ضخيم. It doesn't matter. When time comes, فإذا جاء أجلهم لا يستغفرون ساعة ولا يستقيمون. Allah, we are too afraid. One person talking, we are too afraid. The whole communities. What are we going to do? What do you think? What do you think? Ay, we have Allah. We have Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Sahaba, قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا هو مولانا. Nothing will afflict us, Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote. He is our Mawla, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to conclude part of my khutbah with two examples. I want to tell you who was Abu Sufyan quickly. I want to tell you who was Fir'aun. For no less than 20 years, Abu Sufyan is persecuting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No battle except he attended. Until Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, I'm talking of 13 years in Mecca, 6 years, slowly, slowly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guiding and showing his heart the truth, and Abu Sufyan just after that is reverting to Islam. I want to say on this member, I hope that President Bush will be a Muslim. Somebody told me, we don't want him in Islam, Islam is not yours. Trump can be Muslim. He can be like Abu Sufyan, Abu Sufyan, Abu Sufyan. Then he takes Shahada and become our president in this masjid. مَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala كَتَبَ عَلَيْهِ أَوْ كَتَبَ لَهُ هِدَايَةً, no one can stop him. Abu Sufyan persecuted Rasul. Abu Sufyan strategized and planned together with a few Ru'asa Quraysh, but at the end he's taking Shahada in the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah can guide him to be a Muslim. So inshallah, let us not forget to make that dua for him, like Rasulullah made dua for Umar ibn Khattab and Amr ibn Hisham, Abu Jahl. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted dua of guiding Umar to Islam. Umar was an enemy of Islam, and after that, Hasuna Islama. Subhanallah, he was so committed to the extent that this is Al-Farooq that we know. Even the West say Omar the Great, they call him Omar the Great. So inshallah, we make dua that Allah guides him. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften his heart. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show him the truth, and he is not harmful on Muslims like he said. On the other hand, there is Fir'aun, who persecuted Banu Israel, who believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for years and years. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ فِرْعَوْنَ عَلَى فِي الْأَرْضِ. This is Surah Al-Qasas. Allah says that verily Fir'aun exalted himself, he raised himself on the earth, above the earth. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. Then he divided and ruled. Na'am, divide and rule started. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. He divided people into different categories. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِنْهُمْ. This group persecuting and humiliating the other group. وَيُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ, slaughtering their sons. Because he was afraid that a child would be born who would take his place. وَيَسْتَحْيِ نِسَاءَهُمْ, sparing their women. Allah says, إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. Allah says that. But when these things are happening, we need to go beyond this. There is a saying in Arabic that رُبَّبُوَا نَافِيَةً. Now, something harmful, there can be good in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that this was not meant to last. وَنُرِيدُ أَن نَمُنَّ عَلَى الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it was a matter of time. Allah says, I intended to bestow my favor and my ni'mah upon those who were weakened, those who were humiliated. الَّذِينَ اسْتُضْعِفُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَنَجْعَلَهُمْ أَئِمَّةً وَنَجْعَلَهُمُ الْوَارِثِينَ. And Allah says that also we wanted to make them to be leaders after all this persecution, and we wanted to make them to be the heir, the inheritors of this land. What was the end of Pharaoh? He refused, right? After 9 ayat, which is the ayat, and he pursued Musa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul fi nafsi surah فَأَحَدْنَاهُ وَجُنُودُهُ فَنَبَذْنَاهُمْ فِي الْيَمِّ فَانْظُرْ كَيْفَ كَانَ عَاقِبَةُ الظَّالِمِينَ. Now Allah says, and which we saved him and his soldiers while they were pursuing Musa and Bani Israel, and we drowned him in the sea. And now look at how bad the end of Al-Zalimun, the oppressors, is. That is how they are. And Allah is mentioning in Quran many times. So any leader who wants to be like Fir'aun, Allah will deal with him. And any leader who wants to be like Abu Sufyan, to see the light, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide them to Islam. This is our start. Allah guides them, and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala misguides them. So having stated this, my brothers, Muslimun went through more than mu'amarat of what we are seeing today in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is called Ahzab, confidence, united alliance. Any name that you hear today existed in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Not all non-Muslims are our enemies, but there are enemies from Muslims. There are Muslim enemies amongst us that they are called enemies within, who are fighting Quran and Sunnah. A Muslim who will take you to FBI and put anything on you, we think he's a terrorist. We Muslims are selling one another. Wallahi, a Muslim is selling one another. Maybe somebody is recording me, they must be. It is impossible that there are not two or three who are using some buttons. They are using for the word, they are looking for the word jihad. They are looking for the word Taliban. They are looking for the word ISIS. May Allah guide you if you are here. May Allah guide you and may Allah take you out of nifaq. Muslims, enemies of Islam, why can't you speak the truth? Why can't you speak the truth? Why betray one another? You have a small problem in business with your brother, you take him to FBI and CIA. You will know me. I have connection with FBI. Denver is in my hand. You will know me. La ilaha illallah. Yet we are lying to one another in the masjid that we love one another. We are selling one another. We are betraying La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Many sheikhs were in trouble. They were reported by Muslims. Not non-Muslims. It is us. في بيوت الله ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. Don't you think that Allah will resurrect? When everybody will stand in front of Allah, نعم, don't you think that Allah will expose you يوم تبلى السرائر. If I know that there is a Muslim who wants to blow any building, I will be the first one to deal with it. If I know that there is a Muslim who has bombs, I will be the first one to call police on him if I cannot come closer to him. Like, in why are we lying on one another? Why should we do that, Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? فَلِذَلِكَ أَحْبَابَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when Arabs, Quraysh, gathered Arab alliances, other tribal groups, and they gathered part of Al-Yahud,
And they gathered some munafiqun among Muslims, because a munafiq is a Muslim, he claimed to be a Muslim. Allah says, وَلَمَّا رَأَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. That is Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, ayah number 22. When Muslims, there were very few in Medina, when they saw the confidence, the multitude of army that was collected, مِنْ ذُنِّهِمْ الْيَهُودِ and Munafiqun, and all tribal, Arab tribes, they came to crush Rasulullah. When they saw this, they have been surrounded. They did not tremble like we're trembling today. They did not shiver like we're shivering today for nothing. قالوا, they say, this is what Allah has promised us and His Messenger. وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger spoke the truth. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا. That tough situation. Medina is under siege. It is surrounded by Quraysh and Al-Mushrikun. They say that this, yani Allah said, it did not increase them except strong iman and submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلِذَلِكَ brothers, I want to finish with the following ayah as my advice to you. Allah says, لَتُبْلَوُنَّ فِي أَمْوَالِكُمْ وَأَنْفُسِكُمْ. You will be tried. Anyone who thinks that it is the rosy, even when you think that everything is okay, it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. When you have money, Allah is training you with money. When you have wife, Allah is training you with wife. When you have children, Allah is training you with your children. When you have a good job, Allah is training you with that. When you are poor and you don't have money, it is a trial and test. Allah says, I will try you in your wealth and your lives. وَلَتَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا. And you will hear many, many, many things that will annoy you. Muslims are terrorists, all Muslims are terrorists, all terrorists are Muslims. You will hear many things. All Muslims are Al-Qaeda, all Muslims are this and that. Muslims have come to take over America. Muslims have come to introduce Sharia law. La ilaha illallah. You will hear many things that will annoy you. But also, وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا. From atheists and polytheists, you will hear many things that will annoy you. Islam is the target now. Every newspaper or magazine, it is Islam. You can see during campaign, it was Islam, Islam. You can see Islamophobic has won the election. You can see that. These are not my words. Maybe some of you are saying, oh, is he gonna sleep in his house tonight? Yeah, that was campaign. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says with all this, what in just biru, if you are patient enough, patient, waiting for the best from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, waiting for the decision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take care of these affairs, وَتَتَّقُوا, not just sabr of laying back, but also if you continue fearing Allah, fulfilling your obligations, fulfilling masrul hayah, وَهُوَ الْعِبَادَةِ, if you continue doing that, Allah says, فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. So we need to be patient, and at the same time, we need to continue fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to improve our Islam to Iman. We need to improve our Iman to Taqwa. We need to come more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, it is a test, it is marhaliyah, it is just passing by. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a wisdom behind making Trump to be a president. Maybe that is good for us. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. You may hate something and it is good for you. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّ شَيْئًا, and you may love something, وَهُوَ شَرٌ لَكُمْ, and it is not good for you. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Only Allah knows, but you do not know. Astaghfirullah. الحمد لله رب العالمين. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله. اما بعد, I have two announcements that I think are other announcements. One is that Sheikh Abu Zayd Kareem texted me and he says that Sheikh is coming from Minnesota. We have university in Minnesota. There will be a seminar, okay, continuation of the previous one. The Sheikh who is coming is mashallah Ali Mani. And it also gives you a credit, okay? You enroll to be part of the university, and when you do these courses, it also gives you a credit. So he said that it will be on Saturday and Sunday from 5, yani from from 5 to 11. They will be teaching both of them, so he asked me to ask you to join this board program. And when people are talking about joblessness, we don't have job. We have brothers, Brother Ahmad and Brother Abbas. They opened a college. And they are recruiting youths. There is a program, okay? There is a program on IT. If you finish that program, you will get a job, inshallah. And they connect you to a company. They have people who are some head of these companies. So I'm encouraging youths to see them. 6 months, you get a job. Good money, 60,000 to 70,000. Not bad, inshallah. So that you can give us some. And lastly, please, please help the house of Allah. Shura is making efforts to come and have a PowerPoint. We will invite all community members. You asked me to talk to them. I sent them a letter that community want to meet with them. Soon, inshallah, they want to have a PowerPoint to demonstrate our finances and all this. And if anyone has a question, you are welcome, but we need to be respectful to one another, inshallah. Time of fighting and quarreling is gone. We can present our points respectfully, inshallah. So soon, inshallah, Shura is meeting. I'm going to meet with them. We're going to see when are we coming to do a presentation. I'm asking you to help the house of Allah. Please, if you have $10, if you have 100,000 million, put it in the in your account with Allah. Not your account with Imam Shafi or Mumani. Put it in your account with Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. $25, right? Pledge. Pledge $25 to the masjid. We will not bug you a lot. Wa jazakumullahu khair wa aqimis salah wa antum muqinuna bil hijab.